So what might you expect to see if you see an African swine fever outbreak? So some of the things you might expect to see is a relatively high fever. We're talking about the 105 to 108 degrees. Now, that doesn't mean that's the only thing that you might see with 105 to 108 degree fever. Certainly, we can see it with influenza outbreaks, or pigs that are infected with bacterial meningitis or erysipelas can also have fevers that high. But certainly, that is one thing that is indicative of pigs sick with African swine fever, is that they have a really high fever. So really highlights the fact that it's important for our caretakers to make sure that they are carrying thermometers with them. A unique characteristic of African swine fever is that the virus attacks endothelial cells. So those are the cells that line the inside of the blood vessels. So what happens is those cells get infected, the virus replicates in those cells, and then they release and they burst the cells. So eventually that happens often enough, those cells break down, and then the blood starts to leak out of the blood vessels into spots they wouldn't normally expect to see them. So what you start to see is hemorrhages. So you start to see it in areas you wouldn't normally expect to see it. So you might see it here on the picture on the right. You'll see it in the ears, in the nose, sometimes in the hindquarters on live pigs. When we show necropsy photos, you might see a little pinpoint hemorrhages. Those are called petechial hemorrhages. Ekmotic are a little bit larger, or a coalescing of all those little petechial hemorrhages to frank hematomas on some of the organs on the inside. That's can be very characteristic of African swine fever as well. You can see bloody diarrhea as another characteristic, and anorexia. So animals will just be off feed. That certainly is going to be a sign of early infection in animals with African swine fever. Because they're not feeling well, you're going to see a lot of pigs lying down, not wanting to get up, laying there in lateral recumbency. And in sow herds, one of the early signs may actually be an increase in abortions, because the affected sows may be aborting their litters. So really kind of the moral of the story is, the unique feature of the virus is these are things that we see with other diseases. So it is not only things that you'll see with African swine fever. So the most important thing is just for caretakers to be aware of these signs. And if they see those signs, make sure they're contacting their herd veterinarian so that their herd veterinarian can make the decision whether or not they need to contact the state and federal officials and initiate a foreign animal disease investigation. And like I said, they really are going to look just like sick pigs initially. Conditions that we see commonly with Salmonella, PRRS, erysipelas, porcine circovirus type 2. What are some of the postmortem lesions that you might see with African swine fever? So some necropsy photos here. So one of the things, again, might be a really large spleen. The spleen's job is to collect all the defective and broken red blood cells, which we know we're going to have a lot of those because that's where the virus likes to live and likes to infect and replicate. So the spleen gets very, very large. You see the photo here in the middle. You can see those are two pigs, same age. The one there on the bottom is a normal pig that is not infected with African swine fever, and the one above it is the same age, same size of pig infected with African swine fever. So you can see that thing has collected a lot of damaged red blood cells. So they're very swollen. It's almost purplish, and it's very common for that to be 2 to 3 times normal. Normal spleen tends to be very flattened out, where this will tend to not be quite round, but very turgid, very, filled with lots of material on the inside. So it's no longer flat, becomes a little bit more oval in shape, and it becomes very friable, which means it's easily to, as you're manipulating, it's easy for it to break and fall apart. We talked about those internal hemorrhages before. You can see some of those cases off to the right there. You see the kidneys. You can see some of the little pinpoint hemorrhages. You can see them in the lymph nodes. Lymph nodes are usually small and very hard to see. They tend to be very tan. Here in these cases, you can see they're blood-filled, so they are dark purple, and they become very enlarged in some of these photos here off to the right. And you can also see some of those collected in the walls of the intestines and on the inside of the both in the walls and in the lumens, or on the inside of the intestines as well. So this was a case that was actually processed at Iowa State Diagnostic Laboratory a few years ago. You can see you've got pigs there with kind of the purple ears, the purple nose, laying around, not feeling very good. Here you can see a picture of the kidneys where you've got the little petechial of the pinpoint hemorrhages, kind of called like the turkey egg kidneys, because they kind of look like a turkey egg with all the little spots on them. Picture here over to the right, you see this large reddened hemorrhagic lymph node around the stomach. Once again, lymph nodes are usually gray and very small, hard to find. This is very purple, very enlarged. Thankfully, this was not African swine fever, but it was PRRS. These pigs had PRRS, circovirus type 2, and salmonella cholera suis. So you can see how similar those were to the pictures that we just looked at on the couple of slides previous, how similar these lesions look like to pigs that were actually infected with African swine fever.